Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the school board meeting for May 9th, 2017. I'll call the meeting to order. First item we'll look at is our approval of the agenda. Any questions or comments regarding the agenda as it's been presented? Or is there a motion for approval?
So moved.
I second.
Any questions, comments? Please read the question.
It is moved to approve the agenda.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next item is recognition of retirees.
First of all, thanks for being here tonight and welcome. The Oskaloosa School District and the Board of Education and the administration, and for the most part, the entire staff. We'd like to take a few minutes here and welcome and honor those individuals who are with us tonight for the years of service and their retirement. I'd like to bring these individuals up, say a couple of words, and I'll have our board president, John Richardson, give the official handshake and award. But these individuals have spent a great number of years here, and sometimes a simple little ceremony like this does not do them honor and justice, but they have spent a lot of time with a lot of children in whatever capacity and whatever position they've held here within the district. So first and foremost, I'd like to bring up Marion Voss. Marion, come on up here, please. Marion has been with the district for 28 years. Marion has served as a bus driver in our transportation department for those 28 years. And how you could maintain sanity in that bus with those weird kids for 28 years, I do not know, but you can put it on stage. So, Marion, congratulations on behalf of the district. So. And then I thought, well, 28 years is probably the longest reigning individual that we have here. And that's not the case. Jeff Nichols. Jeff, come on up. Jeff Nicholson has been with the district 30 years. So Jeff has been employed in the custodial department and maintenance and has been around, I suspect, Jeff, it's been probably many different buildings. I know for the last few years been with the middle school, and I see you quite often while you're down there. But again, trying to take care of that building, and it looks just as good today as it did back in the when it was built in the late 80s. So,
yeah,
absolutely. So, Jeff, on behalf of the district, thank you so much for being a part of the district and helping us out and taking care of our kids.
Thank you, sir.
We have just a little different award, an award of merit from the Iowa Association of School Boards, and the first one I'd like to bring up is Denise McClellan. Denise, if you would, please. Denise has served in the elementary primarily for the last several years, and maybe for the entire, but for over 16 years in the general music category. She's taken care of our orchestra. She's served in general music with vocal as well, and probably a little bit of there. So very, very important to start that program and build a great foundation, and she has done it well. I know she's had a little help on the side, maybe from her spouse, but outstanding job, outstanding program, and I'll start with Denise down at the elementary. So Denise, thank you so much for 16 years. Congratulations. Next, I'd like to bring up Jenny Foster. Jenny. Jenny has served the district for the past 18 years. A great deal of experience there. I know she served primarily at the high school in the physical education department, health as well, and involved in so many activities, and been a lifelong resident of Oskaloosa. Jane, we can't thank you enough for all the years and all the kids that you have served. I know retirement's going to be a wonderful time. Some of you when I get there, but I know we talked earlier about how it's just great to slow down and enjoy and the grandkids and the family. So we hope that you have many, many great years to come with the family. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And last and certainly not least, Marty Saul. Marty, would you please come up here? Marty has served the district for 21 years, primarily in the elementary building. And again, we've only been in the new building since about 2004, so I suspect that many, many years prior to that, he might have been shifted around from this elementary to that one. But 21 years serving primarily the kindergarten, first grade kids, in that lower primary elementary. Outstanding job. She's known as one of our rocks in the elementary. You are sorely going to be missed, and for all these years and for all those children that you have helped, swiped a few tears away, maybe wiped a few derrieres. Outstanding job, and we so appreciate you. Thank you so much, and thank you so much for those 21 years.
And for the retirees, you're welcome to leave if you want. We could be here a while, and you're welcome to go ahead.
Yeah, exactly. Mr. McClellan has a concert.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, he's right. He gets prepared.
Yeah, he does get ready for a concert.
Yes,
yeah.
He does. Retirees. Next item on our agenda is an annual event each May, recognition of School Board Appreciation Week. Mr. Ryder?
Thank you, Tom. It is School Board Appreciation Week, and on an annual basis, we do like to recognize those individuals who do serve your community, our school district. There's a lot of hours involved in this particular job. You wouldn't think necessarily that maybe it is a job, but in fact, there's so many hours and weekends and nights that you spend looking over materials. So again, on behalf of the administration here, Mr. Vink, myself, I'd like to honor you as school board members. It says, I believe in public education. Thank you for service to Iowa Public Schools. And Shelley, you're on top. So Shelley, Vice President, thank you so much for all that you do. Appreciate that. Amanda's been with us for a couple of months and is learning the ropes very quickly. She's done an outstanding job, and Amanda McGraw.
Thank you
so much. Appreciate you being on the board. Sharma has been on the board now two years.
No.
Oh, it's getting close to 2 years. And a wealth of knowledge, special education, former AEA. And she does an outstanding job and always someone we can lean on. So thank you very much, Sherman. We appreciate it. Craig Van Holsen. Craig, thank you very much, sir. Appreciate your expertise in elementary.
Great.
Mr. Richardson. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Going on
6 years.
And so, again, serving as board president, appreciate your service as well. And thank you very much.
Thank you.
We have two individuals who are not with us tonight, Mr. Carl Drost and Perry Gedrin. But I have certificates here, and I would also like to make sure that we'll pass those out when we get to see and send it to them. So, again, thank you very much for serving on the Board of Education here in the Oskaloosa Community School District.
Thank you. Next item on our agenda is public comment. I did not receive any cards filled out for any public comment tonight. So we will move on to the next item, which is reports. Board reports is our first item. Is there any board member that has anything they'd like to share tonight?
I just want to tell Mr. Dursky, thank you for coordinating the China trip with the kids. We were able to host three girls last week and had a lot of fun. So I know that took a lot of time and coordination with Mr. Dursky and his wife, so thank you for asking our family to host the girls. It was fun.
My pleasure, Amanda. I want to give props to Mr. Hochek and Mr. Schultz because they've been through that process before and they helped out. And really the whole elementary school staff helped out a lot because I was pulled in a lot of directions and they were real flexible with that. So it was definitely a team effort, but totally worth it, and I'm in again.
Greg, do you have a couple items?
Hmm?
Do you have two items?
I can bring them up if you want me to.
Sure.
I had sent out a report in the board packet with the timber. We're proceeding along with that. So hopefully we'll have some type of monetary amount, what he thinks the trees are going to be worth, and kind of the schedule that we're going to be doing. I think later on we're going to be talking about the sale of the construction of the home. I met with Dave and looked through the house, so I'll be trying to figure out what kind of value we should put on the house to sell it for.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So that's my reports that I submitted.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Too many papers. Okay, next item, building reports. Any questions or comments on the three different building reports that we received?
I was glad to see the high school is going to offer a coding class, programming class. It's very good.
Yes.
Ben, good step.
Mr. Bandy, as you listed here, that's something some of the students had requested. Is that right?
Yes. I mean, there are some students that are getting a little bit of it with Project Lead the Way in their principal's class. The robotics also does the coding. And if you take Mr. Sheely, then he's the computer science guru, and he will help you with it. So the kids are asking if they could have that class, and that's been something that they want. It's also something that the state in a few years is going to require us to have. Mm-hmm. So we might as well get started.
I've got a couple items I noticed I wanted to make a comment on. In the elementary report, of course, in the past we've had lots of conversations about student behavior. Mr. Dursky told us some months ago that the goal from the AEA, and Mike, correct me if I'm wrong here, the goal from the AEA is 80% of our kids to be zero or one office referral. And with just 2 or 3 weeks left in the year, we're at 87% of our kids in that building who have been referred zero or one time. So I think a lot of credit to our teachers and our principals and everyone that's involved with that. That's spectacular news. And on the middle school side, the PBIS numbers, again, there's 25 different categories of things that can be a behavior referral to the office, and comparing this trimester. Again, a couple weeks left in the school year, but this trimester compared to the second and even the first trimester, numbers much lower. Mr. Hotek, is that a fair evaluation of the numbers?
Yes, it is. And we've seen less office referrals this year compared to last year. And also as we progress through the year, we've seen less office referrals. We know that our tier two interventions is an area that we want to focus on for next year. But as far as seeing a decrease and the positive results from our PBIS efforts, I think we're really celebrating those.
Okay, great. Thank you.
I just had one thing, too. I saw that the Iowa assessments were kind of starting to look through those. I just wondered when the board might get some of those. Will that be in the,
Jordan
next,
and I will be
in
probably,
the next month, probably?
Well, actually, I'd like to see something maybe at the May 23rd meeting if we can.
That would be
get
awesome.
All the, yeah,
mm-hmm.
I
would
want
awesome.
To get that information.
I'm working on it. Okay.
I'm putting it in the format to share with you.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
thanks.
Hopefully the May 23rd.
Thanks.
Okay. Next item is curriculum director report. I had a problem with some emails not getting to me that some may have received. Was there a report?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
There was a few things
yes.
that Annie Chad and I needed
Thursday.
To work out. But is there any questions on on the curriculum director report. It's in here. I've just spaced it off. Okay, Mr. Ryder.
I've got a couple of items. First of all, congratulations to our sixth grade math team. They went to a competition and actually came home with a first and a third. And so we talked about how that middle school, especially at that sixth grade level and with the dyads that have been created, and how we think they're being extremely successful. But hats off to the sixth grade team, to those teachers, to Molly McCulley, and those kids who went and won that regional math competition. Outstanding job. I've been working on, and Dr. Prothero and I have been looking at the behavioral support plan, and we know we've had some issues in the past with some of our students and maybe some behavior issues and special ed plan. Couple things. One, we got to make sure that we're following the law, and in doing so, we're seeking a great deal of guidance and help, not only from the AEA, but some additional experts that are out there. And for the past two, three, four months, we've been taking a hard look at what are some of the things that we could do differently. And so at our next meeting on May 23rd, I have asked for a presentation to be given on a behavioral support system that is holistic. It really is an umbrella that looks at many aspects of student behaviors, and whether it is special education students, working with student services, looking at mental health care. There are so many aspects to it, along with getting our school counselors involved. And so we've been working with Rosie Warder. I think Dr. Prothero was the first one she introduced Rosie to me, and so we've been doing a number of things. But I've asked Rosie to come and give a presentation to you, the board, and talk about different ways that we can attack and look to continue to improve and solve some of those issues, primarily at that K-8 level. And so I'm excited about some of the things we've been able to do, put some things together. So that'll be at our next meeting on the 23rd. Also on the 23rd, the IO report card, my plan and goal was to provide some information to you, the board, about that IO report card, and getting information together right now. I'd like to be able to provide as much information as I can on the actual IO assessments. Mike Steensma, who actually comes from the AEA, is really an expert on that IO report card, and he said he would love to come and share information with you, the board. So I'm having conversations with Mike, and we're going to see if we can't get him here that particular night. The desk audit. It used to be every 5 years we had a site visit from the Department of Education. They would rotate, come in, look. People from other districts and around us would come in. We might have 12, 14, 15 administrators, teachers come walk through. We would provide them all the information they needed to know. Are our board policies up to date? Are our schedules appropriate? Everything you can think about. Do we meet Iowa code and classes and everything that we offer? Well, they've gone away from that because of the shortage of staff at the Department of Education, and they now simply are asking every single district in the state to provide what they call a desk audit. They're asking for the same information, but now we're actually going to we send everything in electronically. It's the first year, and I'm happy to say, and thanks to our administration, we had no violations, I guess the term I'm looking for right off the top of my head is
citations.
No citations, thank you. you know, that's a great feeling.
It because
any time you can go through an audit or and no citations, I would say I was at a superintendent meeting just last week, and a lot of our area and conference schools were sitting there talking about how they were going to correct their citations, and I'm sitting back and going, we didn't have any. And so it was a hats off to our administration for being a part of that, and thanks for all that hard work.
One question, is that desk audit now once a year, or is it spread out more?
No, right now they do plan on making sure that that information is being uploaded every single year. It will be a lot of work, but they believe they can save time. And they do plan on concentrating on those bottom 5 to 6% of school districts who do struggle. So they may come back and say, hey, we're not going to worry about checking with you next year or 2 years. But these first couple of years, I would not be surprised if we get information that, yes, we're a part of every desk audit. Mr. Bandy's been very involved with the RPP, which is our Regional Planning Partnerships for Career and Technical Education. CTE is very important in our district with all the things we've got going on. I kind of put Mr. Bandy on the spot. He asked if he could be a part of that, and we kind of got him on a regional committee. And so he's a part of that. We are looking at what we can do to strengthen our own CTE program with potential welding classes. And there's a new system out there that provides additional funding. And we hope to probably at the June board meeting, July at the very latest, update you, the board, on what's happening in the CTE world and all some of those changes. But again, that's all good for kids. And my last note simply is about the Iowa assessments. They have been taken. We've got the information back, and Dr. Prothero and I will be going over that information fairly soon and getting a report for you for that May 23rd board meeting. Okay? Questions for me? There's a lot of things going on.
Well, we have enough time on the 23rd to do both with Ms. Order and
I think
Iowa tests. I mean, those are huge pieces of information.
There's actually about three big things taking mm-hmm. place, and yes, I believe we can. Yeah, I believe we can. We may have to limit ourselves to 25 to 35 minutes per mm-hmm. session. If we don't think we can, then we may have to push something off to June, but
okay.
The goal is to get those in. Also, right in front of you, before you walked in, I wanted to make sure that I explained this. I gave you a handbook, draft number 5. I met with the there's probably 10 more to come.
We weren't doing it.
Yeah. Anyway, this draft is what I met with met the administrators and some teachers last night in my office. We went over a number of those items. Again, this is not it's not done, but I think it's getting better and closer. We had some great conversations with the teachers. They had some suggestions on what we could do to improve it, and I was extremely happy and thank those administrators who did show up last night. And then the other thing is the board policies that have been affected by the Chapter 20 legislation, and that's that other stack of paper. These are going to dramatically impact that handbook because several of these have been changed. And because of that, we're going to have to have some conversations about how we may have to alter some of these, and then how it's going to fit back into that handbook. So I would like to have a conversation, short conversation in May at the 23rd meeting, and then come back in June is when we're primarily going to do most of the work. This only needs one reading because it's a change in Iowa law, so it will not take two. We can finish this hopefully in June, at that June board meeting, and then apply it to the handbook.
Okay? All the stuff in May, if we could get it ahead, like even the reports and stuff,
yep.
would make it mm-hmm. so we could potentially get
yes.
through.
And not a couple of days, but actually right. a full week and a half ahead.
The agenda
yes,
for the
more than a couple of days.
Yes, we'll make sure we get it to
the
you.
The agenda for the June meeting traditionally is fairly short. So that
not this summer though.
Well,
okay.
There's room for some of these things to be included
yes.
with that.
So that's all I have.
All you
sorry.
Can. All right. Thank you very much. Next item is approval of minutes, financials, and abstracts. On the minutes, we have April 6th, 11th, and 25th. We have the minutes presented to us. Any questions or comments on those? Financials, Chad, is there anything you'd like to highlight for
well,
us
of course,
there?
Yeah, certainly for the general fund, management fund, PEPL fund, you'll see the bulk of the semi-annual property tax payments, and they're coming in pretty well with very few delinquencies, so timely dollars on that is always helpful as well. Other than that, pretty simple. As you can see, kind of both with our PEPL and our capital projects fund, trying to hold down expenditures in those areas just to for larger projects that we'll be having coming through over the summer, obviously two of which we'll probably talk about tonight, and then always have the annual concrete updates, particular projects at bathrooms and the like in facilities. So otherwise I think fairly status quo.
Okay. you. On the abstracts, I did have a question on those I asked Mr. Ryder about earlier. Bottom of the fourth page, I'm familiar, of course, with the Wanders Reading Program, but I see a Wilson Reading Training. In case anyone else had other questions on that, could you explain what that is?
Wilson Training, Reading Training, is a program that we plan on sending some of our special ed staff up to Des Moines, I think, June?
3 days in June.
3 days in June, and so you'll see that expense. Wilson's an excellent program for kids who tend to struggle, and the more we can get that teacher professional development, but we are primarily focusing on our special ed elementary staff members right now, maybe a couple middle school as well, but just wanted to explain that. So we have staff going for PD.
Excellent program.
It is a
for struggling learners.
Right.
Yeah. Excellent.
Any other questions on the abstracts?
I asked Chad about three of them, and he explained them. My question on the dryer at the middle school, a $10,000 dryer.
Yeah, I wish Bill Holman was here to discuss that. Andy is here. The one that we've had there for 30 years.
It may have even come over from the old.
I think it was original. And we end up, we don't buy just your traditional dryers. We have the large commercial industrial size dryers. And so, they're not cheap. They're not.
But we spent less than that on a washer and a dryer for the same reason at the elementary. So just curious on why we'd spend $10,000 on just a
that
dryer.
I'd have to ask Bill. Andy,
you got a washer and a dryer also.
I knew we were going to get the dryer. You're saying we got the washer as well? Okay.
I was thinking it said that. Maybe I ask, and that's what I got.
I knew they needed the dryer because that's what that was the one I'm struggling with. And again, they're both extremely.
Yeah,
they're original.
Yep.
Page 21.
Yep. Washer and dryer.
Washer and dryer. Right. Washer and dryer.
Yeah. Because I had it circled too.
So did I.
Okay, there we go.
Yeah, but again, those large commercials and. We hope it lasts another 25 years.
Okay. Other questions? No? So regarding minutes, financials, and abstracts, is there a motion for approval of those?
So moved.
Is there a second?
I second.
Any other questions?
It is moved to approve the minutes, financials, and abstract of claims as presented.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed say nay. Motion carries. Next item is consider approval of softball project specifications and to solicit bids.
I, Mr. Parker, I may ask for a couple of comments, and feel free to stand up and talk. Ryan, as our activities director, has been working through the committees and then looking at options and opportunities to improve our softball field. We can go way back and talk about the problems associated with the previous one, but for the most part, he's been working with Bob Nielsen from Gardner Associates. They've done an excellent job trying to get everything in order and lined up. I know we still are planning to use the current softball field for this summer. Feel free to talk about that and what you're going to do there, but we think Bob's plans, along with everything we need to do to get this project started, it's a good project.
Yeah, so we had a committee together, and you guys all know this. We presented in front of you know, multiple times, but one of our last things was we wanted to make sure that we was playable at our current field. When we made a few adjustments to that is brought in some more portable restrooms, one being a handicap, to make it more handicap accessible. The city came in late last week and improved the road, and I think even Mr. Ryder even took some pictures of it. I'm not sure if you forwarded them on or not, but we can do that as well. And what they did is brought some new rock in, really compressed it, watered it, and then we brought Benson Stevens in, I think yesterday it was, and they put some of that dust control, but it's also helps that compaction down as well. And so it's like, almost feels like you're walking on concrete, which is a much added improvement. Thursday, they are planning on digging the holes for the railing, and then hopefully early next week finishing that railing off. So those improvements, along with you know, minor ones here and there, are hoping that it added safety, but also looks okay too, you know, and to get us through the season.
Mm-hmm. When did you expect the railing?
The railing, we're hoping early next week, Monday or Tuesday.
Okay, so
yeah. We're waiting on a couple guys that are on vacation on our
two weekends staff. Down the road to walk back there. That's yep. What I would say.
I hope you, you know, by the end of next week, I'm hoping yeah. You can walk back there okay. And see the drastic improvements. The road's the number one thing. When we looked at this entire thing, that was the major thing that had to get sort of updated and helped on the safety side of things.
On my notes to you, Tyler Riley in FEH is not going to be involved in this particular. We had talked with Tyler off and on about specs for certain things with the softball field, like dugouts, etc. But he is not going to be involved with this particular project. However, Bob Nielsen is, and Bob is the one who's going to be able to handle all the bid specifications. Bob's got a great deal of experience in doing so, and so. Questions about this particular motion. We're excited to get this thing started and get it rolling so that the kids can have a quality field next school year.
Mm-hmm. One question. I think we talked about this a month or so ago regarding soliciting bids, that there's a number of things that local
yep.
contractors will be able to supply. Is that right?
Yeah, and so we talked about this is just basically phase one of the bid, moving the dirt and getting all that done. There's also potentially the bleachers. There's potentially the, what was the last one, guys? I can't remember what the last one was offhand. Put me on the spot. But yeah, there is potentially contractors in town being able to help with these, as well as our building trades.
Mm-hmm. So. And I want to reiterate on the building trades. I would not feel comfortable just taking our building trade kids, because we do have kids that come up to us from Eddyville, and if Eddyville and or Dr. Cook at Eddyville expects our kids, their kids, to actually build and construct a house, I would probably say I would not even recommend. Mm-hmm. I had conversations with Dr. Cook last week, and he actually was the opposite. He goes, that's an absolute great opportunity, and if you can add a little design, if you can add plumbing, if you can add some electrical and concrete work from the ground up, he was actually quite excited for us and said, absolutely, use our kids however you need to. So Mr. Bauer, Mr. Parker, and I are going to have to sit down and have some conversations about how we can utilize our building trades more effectively for not only the concessions, restrooms, press box.
And even dugouts.
And the dugouts. Mm-hmm. So right. I think we may be looking in that direction.
And, you know, some of that, like, to answer your question, Tom, is some of it can't be done, but some of it can.
Sure,
understand. You know, the irrigation and different things that have to be improved and involved in this bid, so.
This comes out of which fund?
This would be a statewide penny.
The statewide
yeah,
penny
construction,
fund. Okay,
statewide
Pebble.
Penny. You could use parts of it for Pebble if you okay. wanted to, but I don't think Chad and I have ever.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine.
Yeah,
I just wondered.
For buses.
Yeah,
our
that's transportation.
What I
so
super,
I think our statewide yeah. penny is very healthy,
okay.
And this is where we would use it
okay.
for construction. Other questions for me, Mr. Parker?
We just appreciate all the work you've mm-hmm. done on this.
Yes,
not nine. That's nine people person committee, so they put in some work too.
Okay.
So
thank you, Ryan.
So, Mr. Ryder, can you give us a quick description of what we're voting on, just so it's all
well,
clear?
Yeah, really. What you're voting on is really nothing more than to approve the project and allow Bob to go out and solicit bids and start that paper process so that we can go out and say, okay, what do we expect the cost of the dirt work to be done, and what is the cost of this? You're not approving as far as spending any money and purchasing of rock or gravel or lights or chain link fences at this point. It simply is to start that other process.
When would you expect we would be looking at some hard dollars to vote on? How far down the road?
Yeah, I would probably guess sometime in potentially July, early July.
Okay.
I think we could probably get that process moving.
Okay.
Because our last meeting, we were waiting on getting this from...
Correct,
right.
Yeah, waiting for Bob to finish up the last bit
right.
of the specs.
And we wanted to make sure the safety issues
right.
were,
yes.
were
and
addressed
Ryan's
for this year.
Pretty much taken care of that, and we're comfortable with that now.
Yeah.
And I think what we're trying to do is we need to get this out there, because when you submit the bids, then you have so many days after that to open the bids, and then you got to go through it, and we want it. Summer is the time that we need to be doing this. We don't want to be behind the eight ball.
Yep.
Okay, any other questions, or is there anyone interested in a motion for this?
I'll move.
Second, is there a second?
I'll second.
Other questions? Question.
Is one to approve specifications for the softball field project and to solicit bids for the same.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
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 Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next item is consider approval of architect contract for the high school gym renovation.
Yeah, the contract that was sent to us from Tyler Riley, Chad and I are able to look through it. But legal language is legal language, and the information was sent to Greg Life, and I think Greg's still taking a little extra time and reading through this. Again, I've worked with Tyler before, I've worked with FEH, and I've been nothing but extremely happy with everything that they've done and how they've delivered a final product. This, we had some conversations at our last work session, our meeting about what we would like to see in this particular project with air conditioning and heating units for the high school gym, new roof, new exterior, and you know, making it useful again for the next 40 years. We think it's a great project. I would like to have some type of a motion here that's going to approve pending. Greg's final okay on the contract itself.
Yeah.
Again, I'm excited about the project, but sometimes when it comes to legal language, I would want to wait and make sure that there's nothing in there that could catch us. And if we think that there's something as simple as making payments on a given day, well, we'd like to make sure that payments are within 30 or 45 days so that it gives the board time, and there's all sorts of things that we want to make sure.
Yeah. Mr. Ryder, one thing I didn't see in here is like a time frame. A lot of times we.
What page are you?
Well, it's not in here.
Yeah.
I look. Gotcha. So, liquidated damages. If there's not a date when it's not completed, do you have in mind something to add?
Yeah, and at this particular time. I would not come out and just say, yeah, we're going to put something there that has to be done by this specific time and or, because then sometimes people shy away from that. Mm-hmm. As far as a time frame, we would like to be able to get things rolling with the bid process, get things going here in June and July, and then get this thing started. It may be in August. We've talked with Mr. Parker already about how this project could interfere a little bit with the start of school and volleyball season, but we'd sure like to get most of the outside work and heating and cooling done before October, early October, to beat the weather.
Much like on the softball side, we don't have firm numbers on.
No, we don't.
This, so we're looking at just the scope of the project right now.
Correct. But the timeline, again, we're looking to get this done prior to the cold weather of December. Any other questions? Again, my only recommendation would be to approve pending a stamp of approval from Greg Light.
Any questions? Is there a motion for approval on this?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Your turn.
Second.
Other questions, comments?
Is moved to approve the standard form of agreement between owner and architect with FEH Design of Des Moines, Iowa, subject to review by legal counsel.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
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 Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next item is consider approval of OSSA tentative agreement and master contract amendments.
I've made a few comments. Chad, feel free to make comments if you would like. We've spent some time, and on a yearly basis, I had the opportunity to sit down with our support staff. And in this particular situation, we were able to sit down, spend about 3 hours. We're able to negotiate out a deal for next year. I want to thank those members of the OSSA representing our associates and custodial and maintenance and bus drivers and transportation department, food service. Essentially, we came up with a 30 cents an hour raise on their base pay, and then for our transportation, that equaled out to be about a $21 a month increase. And overall, it was all about a 1.67% increase. Chad can get into the real numbers as far as how do we go to the state and let them know what that percentage is. But hard to compare this year's agreement with last year's when you have to take out all the insurance and all those other things as far as the package deal. But increase on salary was 1.67. Questions for me and or Chad? I believe it's a 1 year.
Yeah, just a 1 year. That's the strike through.
We typically have had 2 years in the past. We've had 2 years, but this year is just a 1 year. Just a quick comment. I am going to continue working on a handbook for the support staff. It's going to be similar to the certified staff. I too will also work with them, bring individuals in from each group, sit down, have some conversations about their particular handbook. So it's handbook season, and we're completing an awful lot. Okay?
I move we approve the tentative agreement.
Is there a second?
I second.
Other questions, comments? Read the question.
It is moved to approve the tentative agreement and accompanying amendments to the master agreement with the Oskaloosa Sports Staff Association for the 2017-2018 contract year, subject to ratification by the Oskaloosa Sports Staff Association.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
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 Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next item is consider approval of salaries for administrators and directors.
In your packet, I sent some information and gave you a couple spreadsheets as to what my recommendations are. Again, a little more difficult this year in trying to work out specifically when you have to look at the insurance. So I kind of stepped back, looked at what that increase of salary would have been for certified staff members, then look carefully at administrative salaries as well as directors, and my recommendation is to provide a 1.3% increase for all administrators and directors. I think the big thing that I need to also have some conversations is to continue looking at their contract days. I want to make sure that those contract days and days that we're asking them to work during the summer, they're being compensated for that. I believe we're in pretty good shape. As of last year, I know we added another 5 days. I'll sit down with especially our elementary administration to make sure that compensation is taking place. But again, my recommendation is 1.3%. Again, this is on salary, and that is equal to a salary increase. Actually, it's, I think, was it 1.33 for certified staff?
1.66.
Support staff was 1.67. Yeah, the $900 was a 1.66% increase.
One thing I'll mention, on the teacher side, the number of days is
186.
And just looking throughout our principals and directors, they're in the range of 220, 230, 260. They're a much longer period of time that they're here in the building.
Yeah, for the most part, it's almost an entire year. There's a couple, there's a few that are a couple of weeks shy of that. And so, again, but we have summer programs going on, and if we're asking them to be there to run either a reading program or whatever it may be, I want to make sure that we double check on the days that we're asking them to be in the buildings. So, conversations, questions for me?
Their insurance is still would be similar to
same
faculty,
as the rest of the
right?
Yes.
So they would be on that same.
That is correct.
Tiered and
they have the same options. They could take an HSA if they wanted.
Okay.
They could be on the single. They could be a single spouse, single dependent, and or family, and they'll have the same insurance options as both the certified staff and portions of the support staff.
Mm-hmm. Questions? Comments?
I have a few comments I made to Mr. Ritter. And he had told me that typically you do a blanket. Is that just typical of most schools to give a blanket increase and not based on performance of each individual?
It is. Partly because of the team aspect. If we know we've got, I mean, in a situation where we really truly have a probationary situation or some struggling, then maybe not so. But when you put the team together, and I rely on them just as much as they rely on me, they rely on each other. From that perspective, that is usually what happens. It's not uncommon. In fact, it's what's common in the educational administration world.
I went and looked at schools our size, spent some time looking at the website, or on different web, I think it's the
IASB
things.
Market data is out there.
Some of our positions aren't where other schools our size are, and I just, one of them concerns me, and I won't mention the name, but just of the amount of hours that we require him to work just seems really low for the responsibility that he has. So that was kind of why I asked, is it just a blanket increase, or do you look at the responsibilities of that director?
And when you look at directors and you take a look at the amount of hours, all of those things do play into that. And typically I have an open door, so whenever there's a concern from an administrator and or director, and we sit down and have those conversations, compensating that individual appropriately and somewhat to market is always a topic. I can tell you that superintendents right now are sending emails back and forth amongst our network, because we're all looking at, they may be looking at new positions and or new individuals coming into those positions, and they're all asking, what do you pay this individual for that position? What do you pay this person? And so we always try to compare, and we're in the ballpark, and in some cases, we know the amount of hours our administrators and directors put in are substantial. They know it's not a 40-hour week job,
sure.
But we also want to make sure we compensate them appropriately.
And we don't lose them.
Correct.
Other questions? Or is there a motion for approval on this?
I move.
Is there a second?
I second.
Other questions, comments? Please read the question.
It is moved to approve the salary increases for administrators and directors as presented.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
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 Those opposed, say nay.
Nay.
Motion carries. Next item is consider approval of wages for other support employees.
Yeah, we have a few individuals who are not a part of either union and who are not technically in certified and or support, and they're not directors and or administrators. We have some kitchen managers. We have individuals who are in the central office, as well as some technology. And so my looking at some salaries and wages and looking at days, made a recommendation to you that those individuals receive a 1.67% increase on their salary. Those individuals also then, of course, that same health insurance coverage that's been offered to everybody else will be offered to them. And so just questions you have for me regarding that.
Motion for approval of this?
I move.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Any other questions or comments? Please read the question.
It is moved to approve the wage increases for other support employees as presented.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
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 Those opposed, say nay.
Nay.
Motion carries. Next item is consider revised board policy series 100, educational philosophy, second reading.
Technically, though, we're not going to have a second reading.
Thank you.
Legally, we have to read through, and I spent the time at our last monthly meeting going through. But were there any questions, concerns? again, no recommendation changes from the School Board Association on the 100 series that deals with educational philosophy. There are a couple of those 100 series policies that will be in the handbook, potentially, especially with dealing with the overall harassment type of policies. So questions to me, otherwise after tonight, my recommendation is to approve, and we'll get those updated. And then we'll take a look at one single policy in the 1000 series, which deals with the George Daly. Mr. Parker, myself, and Randy Wright are looking at that. And then we'll jump into the all of the policies that need to be changed because of the Chapter 20, mm-hmm. which then will affect our handbooks. But okay. So, again, those are legal changes. We'll just have to do what we have to do. So, any changes you want to see or 100?
I guess I thought they're fine, but I think it behooves the board to make certain we do what's in the policy, because we had some questions with some of it. Do we really do this community piece, and do we really do that communication? And so I think it's good that as a board we need to really make certain we're doing what we're supposed to do. So that would be my only comment.
Okay. Are there questions, comments, or is there a motion for the board policy series 100?
I move to approve.
I second.
Any other questions, comments? Please read the question.
Please move to approve for the second and final reading, revised board policy series 100, educational philosophy as presented.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next item, consider revised board policy 210.8, board meeting agenda, first reading.
I'll just hand this over to Craig. Craig made a recommendation or would like to see something, so I'll just refer to Craig.
Yeah, so with the last board meeting, I wasn't happy with my board behavior and how we represented the board to the community. And it really bothered me a lot, and I started thinking we really need to do something to make some changes so that we're working together instead of, I feel like we're fighting. So with that being said, I wanted to look at, is there a way that we can have with amongst our board a little more transparency? Because sometimes I feel like we're getting off task in some of our meetings. And I really feel like we need to stay with what we're supposed to be talking about with our agenda. And that way, I think we'll all be more informed. What I did this time is I submitted this example of what I'm looking to change. I submitted the timber report. I submitted a report to the board that's on the building trade. What I found is, when I submitted the reports, I was more thoughtful, and also when Tom asked me to comment, I really didn't feel like I needed to share unless I thought the public needed to know, because what I've done is informed the board on what some of the activities that I was involved in and what the progress was. So what I was looking at doing is, if a board member wants to share something like has happened before, we need to know kind of what they want to talk about, so there is no surprises. And that's what I've told the board before. You probably know my patent answer. I don't like surprises. I just, if we're going to talk about something, let's be open and honest. Mm-hmm. So that being, like I said, I have some type of proposal, but I'm open to changes with the proposal, so we can make it a workable document for all of us. So what I've proposed is that all board members submit reports 2 days prior to the meeting date on the committees or items they wish to share. The reports will be put on the school website when submitted. The reports may be read by board members if they wish. But again, I have no problems if we want to change that or tweak that or make revisions to this so we can be more concrete and more on task with what we're supposed to be doing here as a board.
Okay.
share your concern that I want to make sure we're meeting the spirit of the open meetings law. Mm-hmm. So I think that we want to make sure that we don't get off task during board reports. And I did a little bit of looking since in between meeting times just to kind of see what other schools were doing. And I did it, not scientific, I probably looked at 25 or 30 different board agendas, and I found like three that had board reports, and others maybe managed it differently. There were some that still had it. But I wonder if we need to move to maybe this level of structure. And what I was going to propose, although I'm not sure, given that two people are gone, that today will be the day we should do this, mm-hmm. maybe we need to have a discussion to clarify the purpose of what board reports are for.
Right.
And that may help that. But again, given Carl and Eric's not being able to be here apparently at this meeting, maybe this isn't the meeting to have that. But I wonder if that's a good first step to clarify what is the purpose of board reports. But that was a thought that I had.
One of the thoughts, and I've had lots of windshield time the last week, coming and going here and there, but one of the other things I thought about was that often it seems to me that it's because someone wants to be heard. And I go back and I look at what our primary board goals are, and it's for academic and social behavior. And so maybe in order to help all be heard and to structure up that, those are two items that we always have every meeting. Those are always on the agenda. And so it would give maybe some more structure so people feel that they could be heard on those areas. Another thing I wondered about, just to help us as a board work better, is to see if Ann Morgan would come and provide some guidance for us. She is a former superintendent.
Yeah, and
she with the AEA.
Yes, and she's with the AEA now. So she's had lots of experience in education. Because I don't know that another board policy will help how we work together.
Well, and I have no problem with Carl bringing up some of the topics. It's just, it's like I told you earlier, it's a surprise.
Yes.
And as board members, we shouldn't be surprised with anything that should mm-hmm. be in front of us beforehand. That's the point of the 2 or 3 days agenda packets that are being out in front of us.
Yeah.
That's the whole purpose. So we have some time to study.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just my concern.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. One of the things I wrote down about what's the purpose of board reports, I wrote down, I think what it's not is things that prompt discussion, right? I don't, because they're not on the agenda.
Right.
So that then they're not. And I do agree with you, and I think sometimes we've gotten off task because maybe somebody's wanting to talk about something, and I think just a comment of I'd like to see this on the next meeting probably doesn't violate that. But if we get into back and forth, anything where we're presenting information or getting back and forth in that conversation might not be in the spirit of what open meetings I think are supposed to be about.
I spoke with Greg Leif, our attorney, about this some, and in the past, we've never voted on anything, obviously, during board report
right.
time. But if there's a topic that comes up out of the blue that could lead to a vote at a future meeting, we should tell the public needs to know about that in advance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so what all of you have mentioned, it sounds to me like would be leading that direction, so the public is aware of whatever that is discussed.
Those were just thoughts that I had, but again, we've got at least two board members not here, so, and this type of topic to me seems like we should get everybody's.
Well, they need their voice. We need their voice in how they feel about this.
Yeah,
I have a problem. And Amanda, how do you feel about this?
I think I already told you how I felt.
Well,
I think it's just a way to silence people.
And I'm not, the point of it is I'm not trying to silence Carl. Carl and I, we have our differences, but at the end of the day, we're working together. We're working together with several different projects. We can agree to disagree, but I just would like to know what he's going to talk about beforehand so I can kind of at least prepare myself. I brought this up partly for me because I wasn't happy with my behavior, how I'm responding. And it's because I'm just not prepared for it. It's a surprise.
So maybe it's more of an issue of how we're working together than it is board policy. So maybe it's...
I think it's a sign and symptom of that.
Yeah.
I agree. I agree with that.
That we need.
You know, and I believe everybody here is here because they care about... Nobody would put this much time and effort in if they didn't care about kids and education here. And I think we're not always going to agree. We're going to have some disagreements. Mm-hmm. But I think if we can better productively disagree and discuss some of those maybe topics where there have been disagreements or surprise or whatever, I think it could be likely that some of our best decisions would come out of those types of conversations mm-hmm. if we could get to having those. And again, I usually don't respond, probably because I'm overly worried about, you know, I don't want to cross over into that open meeting piece, and we're not supposed to have discussions about things that aren't on the agenda, or so I think.
No, and to me, that's the biggest concern, that, you know, that you guys have that conversation, and maybe you're going to want to bring somebody from the School Board Association or somebody who's an expert in open meetings law, and maybe that we just need to bring in Greg, our local attorney. But to me, the biggest question deals with the legality of having conversations that are not and have not been introduced and put on the agenda.
Mm-hmm.
And to me,
mm-hmm.
that's the biggest concern. And so there's a legal question there about when people look at an agenda, they should understand and expect what is going to be discussed and talked about at any open public meeting. When conversations start going awry and going here or there, that's when you kind of get yourself into trouble. And I just would want you as a board to protect yourselves about areas that have not been on the agenda.
And I think we should talk about things where there's differences of opinion. So again, I don't want to silence, to your point
no, absolutely
earlier,
not.
I don't want to silence any ideas.
No.
I want to encourage probably more of that. And, but let's be prepared, and then let's mm-hmm. let's discuss them.
Mm-hmm.
So, but again, I think that this might be a topic to
everybody
have again instead
so,
of
right. So what
do
I'm
an action
to say,
maybe tonight. That
right.
would be. And
what
again,
what I'm hearing is say we need to table this until we have all full board.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you guys are hearing?
Yes.
Okay, I have no problem with that.
Yeah. Okay. Again, I'm not necessarily wanting a different policy. I want a different practice, maybe.
Yeah. And that's where maybe we need specific training as a board together.
Yeah.
And so either the School Board Association
School Board
and would be
Ann
outstanding.
Morgan.
Yep, would be outstanding.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. What do you think?
Just say. Well, I think, again, I've not sat down with Carl and talked to Carl, but I feel like when I'm listening to Carl here, he's focused on academics. He's focused on bringing kids back to our district,
mm-hmm.
test scores, which that seems to be a conflict with you two. And, you know, when you go back, I pulled up our agenda since August 25th, since the beginning of school. And when you look through our agendas, some months there's zero items about academics that should be a concern.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's probably what Carl, you know, he's passionate about that. And so he wants to talk about that. I think we should be talking about it instead of talking always about softball, which I don't disagree with.
On the agenda,
I don't
right?
disagree with softball.
Mm-hmm.
I think we should have moved a long time ago with it. I'm just saying we've talked about it how many times, but we don't talk about how to get kids back in our district or why they're leaving.
Mm-hmm.
You know, test scores. Let's talk about that. Let's not spend so much time bickering back and forth
right.
about things that we can't.
And test scores will come once a year, and they are what they are, and no, you can't change those
right.
once they're there, but you can change.
People look at our report card. I work with a kid that mm-hmm. decided to go that way because he looked at the report card, the Iowa report card. So we have, whether or not we think it matches up or aligns or we agree with it, people look at it. That's
mm-hmm.
why they don't come here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there's other reasons.
I know that, Tom.
You've seen the survey, don't ignore it.
Well, back to
so let's go back
the
to stay on task.
Yes.
Yes.
Open
so,
and rolling
so,
out. Don't ignore those results.
So what we need to kind of look at is, and I have no problem, but sometimes I think what happens is we use that off-board time to discuss some of those academic or the test scores. So maybe what we need to do is try to do a transition or something, so more of that is during these formal.
I would like that.
Spend more board time on that.
Because those are our goals.
Yeah.
That's the important part that we have set for our goals.
Because again, I think more than, and I know Carl uses the board time for that or has, but more than just him is passionate about that kind of stuff. All of the work that we have done, and we need to make sure we put it on the agenda. I completely agree.
We know when the test data is in, so it's just a matter of saying on certain months we're going to talk about certain things. So we could schedule that.
Yes.
A short,
we can build a calendar. Yep.
And we have for 2 weeks from now.
Right.
So I don't know if there's anything else to do.
Let's table it, and then we'll have a, and maybe you, Sharma, you can contact somebody to see about the whatever.
The training?
Yeah, training, okay. And we can move forward with that. Thank you, guys.
Yes, thank you.
Thanks for getting us moving.
Yes.
We have one personnel item.
Personnel items are next.
Yeah, we have one personnel item, and that is an appointment. No resignations or retirements in addition to what we had tonight here. The board approval form that you should have received is for Alice Bowling.
Alicia.
Alicia.
That was the Alicia. A. There's an A in the end of that.
Oh, it's Alice. I couldn't read it.
I couldn't.
He wrote it fast. But Brett Spurgeon has served our district for the last 3 years as our Volk Ag instructor, FFA, and he submitted his resignation a month or two ago because his future wife is going to be working in the medical field up in the Mason City area. He hated to go, but marriage is marriage, and he's actually going up north to look for a position up there somewhere. So that opened up our Volk Ag position. Mr. Bandy has worked diligently the last couple of weeks and been looking for a long, long time. Brought in, I believe, three other individuals, I can have him speak to, I'll call her Alice, but Alicia's credentials, and anything else you want to say as far as making a recommendation for this young lady?
Talking with her references, they all feel that they didn't want to lose her, number mm-hmm. one.
So that's a good sign.
Yeah, especially when you call them and they go, what? So she was looking to get closer back to Bloomfield. She's already got 2 years underneath her belt.
Right.
She is very energetic, always on the ball, and wanting to help kids. And so that's where we're at. She when I talked to her about what we do and what we're farming and those things, her eyes lit up. She's also talking about welding and doing those kinds of things, the case classes. She'll be taking training this summer, not only for one, but for probably two. Brett did get a STEM grant for one of them, so he's going to turn that money over so that she can train. So I think one training's in Alabama, the other's in Michigan. So she'd be traveling with them. But everybody that interviewed, and that was the CTE group, as well as the Tim and I, we all felt that she was a cut above everybody else.
Okay, good.
Any questions, comments, or is there a motion?
I'll move.
Is there a second?
I second.
Any other questions or comments? Question.
This move to accept the superintendent's recommendation of the appointment of Alice Bowling as high school agricultural sciences teacher starting with the 2017-2018 school year at the BA Step 3 salary level of $38,227.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next is conduct public hearing on sale of student construction house. Want to speak on that?
Yeah, just briefly. each year, we have it in board policy how we go about selling the student construction house. First item is to conduct a public hearing and give the public an opportunity to comment on the sale. And after completing that, then the board has a time where they work on setting terms of sale and process of sale, and that's what Mr. Van Holzen is working on. But we would look to tonight to accomplish this public hearing so we can move on to the next step.
Okay, it's the standard three times. Mm-hmm. Okay, by law, I have to call this out three times in case anyone in the room wants to speak on that. So is there anyone here to speak on the sale of the student construction house? Apparently not. Second time, anyone here to speak on sale of the student construction house? Third opportunity to speak on the sale of the student construction house. And we'll close the hearing. Next item is conduct. Is this on here? Oh, yep. Conduct public hearing regarding the 2016-17 budget amendment.
Yeah, if you'll remember, last month we approved the publishing of the budget amendment, which just changes the statutory dollar amount, in this case for the other expenditures item, to account for the remaining debt payments, in this case to the city and county, when we closed our bonds in January. So it's been that amendment occurred to publish. Current budget has been published as of April 25, so I look for your approval, and I'll file it with the auditor of state, auditor of the county. There is no tax increase associated with this. It'll just involve the funds that are on hand.
Okay. Do you have a motion that you can tell us in advance what that would be?
Yeah, adopt the 2016-2017 amendment of current budget as proposed and published on April 25, 2017.
Okay. Questions? Comments? Is there a motion?
The hearing
yeah,
first.
Yeah, I think you have to do another hearing.
Yeah, 17 and then 18.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we'll do same format. Thing. Okay. So for the three different times, is there anyone here to speak on the 2016-17 budget amendment? Second opportunity, anyone here to speak on the 2016-2017 budget amendment? Third opportunity, anyone here to speak on the 2016-2017 budget amendment? Nope. That hearing is now closed. Next item is consider approval of the 2016-2017 budget amendment. Anything, Chad, to add to this?
I don't think so.
Okay, questions, or is there a motion on this?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second. Or you, whatever.
That doesn't matter.
Any other
you
questions?
Said it. I did a nonverbal.
I did that in February.
That's right.
Please read the question, Chad.
It is moved to adopt the 2016-2017 amendment of current budget as proposed and published on April 25, 2017.
All those in favor, please vote by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, say nay. Motion carries. Next item is review subsequent meeting date. Looking at May 23rd, the items I had written down were handbooks, Iowa assessments, Iowa report card, a special ed plan, and potentially a personnel item if there's any hirings or resignations that could be also done at that time. Is there anything in addition to that?
Just the fact that those are the major items, depending on how long. I think we could push one of those off, but we'll make sure that we look at it very carefully and provide you with all the information ahead of time. So if there are questions, but May 23rd and we'll...
May 23rd at 7 o'clock.
Okay, will we talk about additional staff that we will hire, not to replacement staff, but how we're going to shift or...
Yeah, actually... Yeah, I can talk briefly about that. There's a couple of sheets of paper that I gave you ahead of time. One dealt with the elementary sections and the class sizes from the projected numbers that we're looking at the elementary. In the kindergarten level, we're looking at right now 9 sections in our K-prep and or kindergarten. We're looking at 8 sections across the board from 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th grade, and 7 sections at the 5th grade right now. So those numbers look really, really good at this point.
Mm-hmm.
they're about as good as you're going to find anywhere around. So we're happy that we can keep those lower numbers and in the primary grade. There was another sheet that I provided and passed on to you that comes from the middle school. And we are looking at a new schedule that deals specifically with 6th and 7th grade. And just wanted you to look at that. And that will show you a couple. I think there's some TBDs to be determined. We're looking at hiring those two positions for some additional reading help and language arts. So at the elementary, we're also, and I'll get more into that particular special ed plan and how we're going to be able to utilize the people that we currently have, the positions we have, along with the AEA. So we're looking at probably at least four additional people, but two are at the middle school. We're looking at a high school science staff mm-hmm. member and a high school at risk right now.
So if we could kind of have a rundown and maybe.
Yeah, and that is information to start the whole conversation. And I was hoping that I could actually have names and where those people will be placed.
I've added that to my list as well.
Thank you.
Anything else?
No.
Chad, anything else?
Confirm 7 p.m. for the 23rd.
Yes, 7 o'clock p.m. May 23rd.
Okay,
yes, good. I did mention that. Yep. Very good. Thank you all for being here. This meeting is adjourned.